We run a small school here. It's the Annapolis Valley First Nations School. And we deal with youth from grade primary up to grade 12. And we also work with some adult education students. And we deal with some students that have some learning challenges. And we also run a GED program that allows older students to get their GED. Anyone can participate. We get a real mix of people, from middle school students up to older people that are trying to get their adult education diploma, some university students as well. So we have a couple of aims. With the school-age students, what we really want to do is allow them to get their grade 12. For the students that have learning challenges, we want to work through with them and give them the opportunity to get up to their grade level, either in reading or math or whatever the subject may be. We do want to introduce some Indigenous education as well. We do some classes for culture. We do some language classes as well. We with the middle school students, we do a lot of language classes, which gives them the opportunity to learn about their culture and their language. We also bring in a few people from outside, be it elders or be it guest presenters, that will do classes for Indigenous art. We also do some computer classes as well. I think in a couple of ways. One is giving people the opportunity to learn a little bit more about their culture and language. Another is just the opportunity to graduate and giving people the opportunity to go on, either do post-secondary education or get into the workforce. Yeah, I think with the varying ages and abilities, we have to work with quite a few different groups of people. So it can be difficult to match it to their ability level, be it subjects, be it other work. So we have to work with a lot of different varying abilities and also a lot of different subject matter at the same time. So we've done a tutoring program for a few years in the past, I think around 5 or 6 years. And then this is the first year that we're offering the school program. And in the past, we would work with different ages and abilities, but it would be more of an after-school program. Whereas this year, we're running more of a regular school hour day. Especially students that have struggled in the public school system, I think that they're able to excel more here because we can focus a lot more one-on-one, small groups, and have the ability to not only deliver information about their culture, about their language, but also to improve their grade level in reading and math and other subjects. Yeah, we do work with both middle and high school students and adult learners. And with the adult learners, we focus on a couple of things. One is allowing students to get their GED. So if they have that opportunity, they can get their GED and then go on to either the workforce or continue on to college, university, or right into the workforce. And so I think that's really important. And as well as we work with some university students, helping them to get through the university programs. And I think the GED is really important because it allows students to have that opportunity for employment or for further education. I think that having the ability to offer the language classes here and also the ability to bring in elders too is really important for Indigenous education. And I think we've been able to do that and also do some outdoor education, which is really good as well. We've had some workshops with Indigenous art. We've had an opportunity to do some outdoor work with learning about some of the plants and the culture outside as well, which is really interesting, I thought. Yeah, I think we could bring in more elders. One thing I'd like to do is to have a bit more access to different resources. That's one thing that I find can sometimes be difficult, is getting curriculum materials, for example, for Indigenous students. So being able to get access to that would really be wonderful. We do some work with the University of Cape Breton. They have an online program for Indigenous language, and that's been really helpful, but it's been a bit of a struggle to find those outside resources. So that's something that perhaps we'll look into in the future. I would like to see more elder involvement, having the opportunity to bring in more elders and being able to learn a little bit about the history and culture that way. We've had an opportunity to do that in the past, but I think even more so would be a really invaluable resource and experience. Yeah, I think we've been able to definitely offer, especially with the different abilities and levels, a chance to give people an education with their culture, their language. So I think there is work to be done, but I think we're getting there. Partly having so many different ages and abilities allows students, even though it can be a challenge, to learn from each other. Bringing in students that are in middle school, but also having older students allows them to learn from each other and kind of pass on their knowledge to each other. The big thing would be to get involvement from the community as much as possible, because there's a lot of resources that way, especially the experience of the community members. And if we can bring in that experience, then I think it makes a big difference. So I'd like to see, as I mentioned before, the ability to bring in more elders and have that knowledge passed down. More outdoor education as well. We've done some of that, but I'd like to continue that. And definitely more curriculum materials, because that's something that we've really struggled to get a hold of. We've been able to get some from the university in Cape Breton, but it's difficult to get, especially materials for middle school students and high school students. So I'm hoping to either have the ability to find those materials or to work with people so I could get them.